Hey, it's your girl T. How are you? Today I will be sharing all the things I think are most important to know if you're getting a curly perm. It's so nice to chat with all my curly babes again, and if you're new here, be sure to subscribe. So I started with type 4 hair and have changed my curl pattern with a Gina curl curly perm. If you're not sure what that is, there's a whole bunch of videos you can go ahead and learn all about that. But today I'm going to share the steps I think are most important to know and follow right after you get your Gina curl. I've gotten 3 Gina curls so far, so I kind of think I figured out what is important to really get the best out of your curly perm. While this treatment does make your hair much lower maintenance, those first 3 days right after you get your curly perm are going to be super duper important to make sure that you get the best curls that you paid for. So we can just go ahead and get started. I don't think this video is going to be too long. So to ensure smooth sailing after you get your Gina curl, rule number 1, the most important rule, is your hair needs to stay perfectly curly in those first 3 days after your Gina curl. Curly, super duper curly. You need to make sure your hair is at all times super duper curly in those first 3 days. I think the instructions you get from the salon, it says to like not do braids or ponytails. And this is because in those first 3 days, your curls are still setting. So any compression or stretch to the curl is gonna reform the curl. I kind of already knew this from getting texturizers in my past. So I had this in mind when I was going home from the salon, but I think this is something everyone that's getting this curl definitely needs to know and understand. My stylist often suggests that you have a spray bottle in those first 3 days, and that is because you're gonna need to really be on top of keeping your hair super curly and frizz-free in those first 32 hours. You might need to retouch your curls throughout the day in those first few days, so having some water on hand is really gonna help you with that and make sure that you are always keeping nice, beautiful curls in those first 72 hours. Super critical 72 hours. During this time, I typically scrunch my hair a lot just so I make sure I always have like a perfect curl in my hair. I don't style my hair by scrunching after that time. That's just a personal preference. But in those first few days, I'm scrunching like all the time, maybe even twice a day. Sometimes small sections that got messed up, I'm scrunching them throughout the day. A big one when you go home, you need to sleep on your face. I know it's horrible for your skin and wrinkles, but it's just a couple nights to make sure that your curls stay perfect and beautiful until your next appointment. So you really want to make sure you're not laying on your curls on that first night, especially not stretching them out or flattening them. I sleep kind of crazy, so I can tell you it's not the end of the world if you flatten out your curls a little bit in your sleep, but you really want to make sure you're getting up right away to fix it. Maybe trying to wake up that night and make sure you're on your face still, but really just making sure as soon as you get up in the morning that you're wetting your hair and reforming your curls again. And you can do this by wetting your hair, scrunching, or kind of like twirling it or wrapping it around a bobby pin or something, and then letting it dry, and that'll make sure your curls are still setting into the proper curl that you paid for. If you like to style your hair with baby hairs in those first 72 hours, it's going to be the time to go ahead and slick down your baby hairs the way you want them, even if you're not going anywhere, because that hair was permed too, and you want to make sure that hair also sets the way you like it. If you leave it kind of frizzy, it's going to stay kind of frizzy for the rest of the time until you get your next perm. So yeah, make sure you just slick those down, maybe not that first night, but the next morning is a great time to do that. Really style your hair how you want your curls to be like, even if you're not going anywhere. On that note, you're not really going to want to plan any major event in those first few days after you get your curly perm. And I know it's like, I just got my hair did, you feeling cute, you feeling popped in, like, but the curls are still setting and your hair is going to behave kind of strangely. So for me, every time I get this curl done, my hair reverts back and forth from like tighter, curlier curls, like my natural curls, to looser curls. So it kind of goes back and forth in that first day or two, and it can look kind of crazy, and then it sets into the curls that I got when I was at the salon. And you're gonna wanna make sure your hair is staying in nice, neat curls on those days. So you don't wanna be out at an event somewhere that you're not able to retouch your curls, or it's gonna get yanked or pulled by something. You don't wanna be somewhere where you have to wear a tiara or a graduation cap or something. It's so important that you try and keep your hair curled like the way you want your curls to be, and you don't want to be stuck in a situation where you can't throw some water on your hair when you need to. On day three, so 72 hours after you get your Gina curl, you will need to condition your hair. This will be the only time I ever suggest co-washing your Gina curl. At this point, I don't think the shampoo is necessary, but you're definitely going to need to give your hair a nice condition. Anytime after this, you must shampoo your hair before you condition. There's a time and a place for co-washing, and baby, this is not it. It is oh so tempting with those gorgeous curls in your hair, but after this first time, do not co-wash your Gina curl. I don't know what the instructions say in regards to that, but in my personal experience, co-washing was a no-go. I've tried it time and time again, and it is a no-go on the Gina curl, okay? And it is super important to cleanse the Gina curl before you put any products on, and that product buildup when you do co-washing just does not flow with the Gina curl. That is the rare time that my Gina curl gets dried out. So if you are co-washing your Gina curl, please stop today. It is not the way. If I feel like my hair is not ready for a shampoo yet, what I'll do instead is actually just a warm rinse. So I'll rinse my hair with warm water, not hot, just warm water, no conditioner, and then I'll apply a moisturizer on afterwards. But baby, please, no co-washes on your Gina curl except for that first time. After conditioning your hair on day three, you're almost home free. At this point, I start brushing my hair again pretty much like normal. I'll add a humectant or water-based moisturizer like Cantu leave-in conditioner and some oil, and I'm pretty much good to go. I still try not to pull my hair in that first week, no tight ponytails or braids. I have actually done tight styles at exactly 1 week, like a ponytail and bun to put my hair under a wig at exactly 1 week with no issues at all. After that time, you can do your box braids or cornrows, buns, tight buns. You should have no issue with that, but in those first few days and probably in that first week, you're gonna not want to do any of that at all. After 1 week, it is smooth sailing with the Gina curl. She is pretty much low maintenance after that, and moisturize my hair about every 4 days to 2 weeks. It really depends on how my hair is feeling and just what she's asking from me. Even if I'm not moisturizing, I like to make sure my hair touches some water maybe every 4 days to 1 week, and she's pretty good like that. So I kind of included like a daily maintenance-ish. I think that is mostly it. I really wanted to make sure you guys got this information because there are so many people booking Gina curl appointments. So I think these are super duper important to know when you get this done. And it's now the winter months, so I wanted to make sure all my Gina curl babies could learn from my mistakes and have really nice and healthy, beautiful curls. My camera is about to die, so I think this is good timing. My contacts are TTI in style Amber, discount code Lavish. My eyelashes are Moxie Lash Magnetic Lashes in style Money Lash, discount code Lavish as well. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe so we can keep getting these beauty tools, tips, and secrets to keep us all slayed, laid, and popping. This is too much hair. Is that my stomach? I'm hungry.